Hello, I'm Mr. Richard, a lecturer in metallurgy, and I preach Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam, which is Sharia free. And here I want to tell you about these tornadoes, floods, and other natural disasters, and why they are taking place in America and other countries like that, and not in a Brazilian jungle. And I lived in Ghana for 14 years. We never had that tornadoes or anything like that. Only once, you know, we had a very strong wind. And otherwise, you know, it was quite nice, calm. And this, people are telling about this climate change and all that, you know, due to carbon, this and that. It is all nonsense. All these things, wind, other thing, is all blown by Yahweh. Yahweh, it brings that, really what it brings in all these things. And our Father, Elohim, Allah, ParBrahm, is greater than Yahweh. So Yahweh is controlled by our supernatural Father, Elohim. That's why Jesus stopped the storm, and also because the other miracle, walking on water and other things. And also he being the Lord of the Sabbath. So here it is, the relationship between Yahweh and Elohim. This is a three candle here, three here. These are the secular world below. And we do social, ecumenical, political affair. And this middle candle is of God, Elohim, Allah, ParBrahm. These parts are Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, same thing. The soul in this one is of Elohim, Allah, ParBrahm. So, in God, you know, we are one Father, and we are a big family, exercising love called agape. I will come to that one later. So this is the situation. This, without this one, they are dead, no light. So this one is the Lord of these things, putting Lord of our souls, Father. As Father is the Lord of the house in your family. So this is a thing, that's why Jesus said, they don't know I'm the Lord of the Sabbath. Yeah. Now, this planet Earth is for the habitation of the sons of man. Here it is, Adam, and under Adam you get you races, under races, tribes and surnames and other things. There's no Jew over here, a Hindu, Sikh or Muslim. They are spiritual self. This is outwardly, and this is inwardly. Inwardly spiritual self. So Jew, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, they are never born, they never die. People, these people, Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, Levi tribe, they are born, they die. And they died during the Holocaust, led by their blind guides. So, in Revelation, 144,000 that would be saved, they're all mentioned by the tribes and not as Jews. This 12 laborers of Jesus has nothing to do with the 12 tribes of Israel. It is made up of 7 in the name of John the Baptist and 5 in the name of Christ. You say 5 are concerned with your heart and 7 with your physical body. remember that Mary Magdalene, she was got rid of those rituals concerning this one. And she became a saint by preaching gospel. That is, the soul in everyone is the same, whether you are a male or a female. Soul represents our supernatural father. So here it is, the royal kingdom of God. John the Baptist baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, and Jesus in the name of his heavenly father Yahweh. And he holds the scripture, Luke 16, verse 16, law and prophets were till John the Baptist. And after that one, Jesus has opened this narrow gate to the royal kingdom of God. So this is a true vine planted by our supernatural Father. So people who want to find this narrow gate, they should be sensible and predestined. So people that soar the ego, if you are egoistic, you can't go there, you can't find it. You are saying, I am all the way. That is not the way. We have to represent our supernatural Father. We need to be sons of the Most High. So this ego of this one is destroyed here, as you destroy a seed, you know, when you plant it. And then it's a plant merges out of that one. And that plant bears fruit and not seed. Identity of the seed is implicit, and spiritual identity which bears fruit is explicit. So this is where here our soul is concerned, and not physical body. So here we have one Father, which is our supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, ParBrahm. And we are all His sons, whether in flesh you are a male or a female. So that's why St. Thomas says, unless a female here, disciple of the rabbis and other people, unless a female becomes a male by this one male here, she cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. So this is the royal kingdom of God. It's different from the kingdom of heaven and hell. That is used to be of the rabbis. This is inside your own heart, not outside. So here you are recognized by your merciful deeds. And here you perform secular works, social, ecumenical, political, for your living. So this is the celestial word of sadhus, Melchizedek. And that's why Jesus said we have to become like here. No money here. And no book here, no book, which is Jewish level, that finishes here. Luke 16, verse 16. So when you go preaching tour, don't take any money in your pocket. No two shoes, no two tunic, and no script. Script means Bible, it's forbidden. So you graft yourself to the true vine, and then you preach gospel from the rooftop. Remember that a Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die. This is what it is, you know. A Samaritan man picked up the wounded person. A Pharisee passed by, a Sadducee passed by. They did not bother about him. So this is the royal kingdom of God. Once you enter this one, you are the son of the Most High, Elohim, Allah, ParBrahm. Like Father, like Son. So you have the omnipotent powers over this one. This is below, and this is above. Now let's see. And here is John the Baptist. John the Baptist, he is a moon. A witness to the light, but not the light. And here are saint, Christ, you know, not Christian. Christian of the book stand nowhere. They are under the domination of their doctor priest, hireling doctor priest. So they don't come into the royal kingdom of God. So this is the of John the Baptist, and they are the messenger. They are the messenger who do the will of our supernatural Father. So, all the whole, this is nature at large. Human being, wind, anything you can mention is the nature that's under here. So, this tornado, which is quite devastating in America, is due to the atrocity the American did in different countries. America has the largest Jewish community, and they are the controlling Mammon and media. So anybody who talks against Jewish people, they will bring him down. No politician can dare to talk against them. Through Mammon and media, they will bring him down. In here, the politician, they know the situation. And here's a Green Party, Dipti head. She made this cartoon. And it was published by Jewish newspaper, and I copied it. And later on they realized it is against them, so they took it off. And asked the MP to apologize. She did, you know, otherwise they would have pulled her down as if they pulled on carbon. So this is the Jewish man with sickle, David's cross on it, bringing bloodshed in all these countries. Take for example Syria. Syria, the President Assad is duly elected president, democratically. And these people which are rebels, are religious fanatics, these Mohammedans, they want to take over that country. And they have taken over Afghanistan. So Russia was supporting newly elected Assad, whereas the United States, they were supporting the rebels, or those people troublemaker in that country. And that is the nature of the tares. Tares are sons of Satan. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30. And they are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. So you will see a lot of them running for Israel for protection. The property price in Israel will rise up with that inflow. The chosen people, they are special people, elite people. Adam was Abram. Oh dear. Hello? No, I'm busy. So, Abram was picked up from Iraq area. Iraq is the cradle of humanity, good people there. and it was planted by Yahweh in the Middle East as Adam and Sarah as Eve, and they were given the promised land as Garden of Eden. In other words, Yahweh created Adam, Sarah, Eve, and Promised Land, Garden of Eden, a demonstration nation. And through them we learn all the moral laws. They have given us practical demonstration. So in that one, they suffered like Holocaust and other things. And we should appreciate their sacrifices in teaching us the moral laws. They are nation of priests, gods, with small g. So when they became unfaithful to Abraham, Jacob had 12 sons. 11 of them were crook. They were telling lies to Jacob. One was truthful, Joseph. But the other were jealous of him. So they sold him as a slave to the Egyptian. As soon as he left the promised land, whatever they were eating, it was getting less and less, or the land was getting barren, because Abraham was not happy, and so the Yahweh who planted that Abram as the faithful sons, he wasn't happy. They became sons of Satan, and so no rain. They have to leave for Egypt. Over there they were maltreated and then brought back by Moses. All this story has been told in the prodigal son. So now it's the end of the age, and Israel was protected for 70 years. After 70 years, there are 5 more years. 5 are related to your conscience. And then atomic war is expected on 14 May 2023. Our Father God knows better than I can tell you. But that's what the Bible say, and that is what I'm telling you. If you calculate, remember, Jesus wasn't born at the same time as John the Baptist. There was a difference of 6 months, and that 6 months is of menorah candle, you know, six. Middle candle is of Elohim. So those people who are faithful to Yahweh, they have the right to live on this planet Earth. Other people who are not faithful to Yahweh, they will be burned or they will die, killed. So people who are faithful to Yahweh, they are tribal people. They are in Africa. Over there they have tribal mark on their faces. And also in the Brazilian jungle, over there also they have the tribal mark on their faces. So these are the two places where you will find Son of Man. Many these politicians, they are psychic. They give you sugar-coated sermons to get votes. Once they get the vote, then they will do their own tricks. They are the ones who are causing problem in the world. And this system, democracy, is not good. In democracy, you reflect the conscience of the people. The dirty-hearted people will be clever. They will be cheating and all that, the clean-hearted people will run a nice democratic government like Russia, China. Over there, you know, the tribal instinct is very strong. Uzbekistan, all these things, you know, the name of the country is after tribe. So being tribal instinct very strong, so they are sons of Yahweh. And Yahweh looks after them. And there are no floods over there, heavy floods, as you can see them in other countries, America and other countries. And no fires burning, you know, like in America, or tornadoes and other things. So people who are not faithful to their tribal fathers, who don't have tribal identity intact, the British or the European, you know, they will suffer the thing more and more in the coming time. America is suffering from coronavirus because they are the people who bombarded Iraq for nothing. Saddam Hussein had no weapons of mass destruction, but they framed him to the general public so that they find an excuse to kill him and destroy the management of that country. Same with Iraq and Libya, they did the same. So these countries, they were faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh, are sons of man. And the Jewish people, they want to make them Jew outwardly. So this time we are passing through a tribulation period of 5 years from 2018, when Donald Trump pressed the tribulation button by declaring Jerusalem to be the capital of Israel. And that caused the problem. And so there will be a lot of these things happening. So the best way for your protection is to enter into the royal kingdom of God that has a narrow gate. And that you do by eating the flesh of Jesus, of what came out of the mouth of Jesus, taking it to your heart, digesting it through the teeth of logical reasoning or intuition, and bring the gospel from your own heart, which is logo, from your own mouth, and that is gospel. Not that you read the book, you know, Bible or Quran or any other religious book. It's no good unless you put it into practice. That you do when you have the knowledge of the oral Torah, which is the lifeline of the people in. So the best way is to have your tribal instinct or tribal identity intact, and don't forget it. Keep your link with Adam, then Adam will save you from this. Adam was created by Yahweh, and that's why Jesus' Hebrew name is Yeshua. There are two words, Yah from Yahweh, Shua or Shiva means the primordial of Adam. So the first born of Yahweh, second Adam. So, because this, you can't have two atoms dividing this country. Jesus came to unite us, not to divide us. So he did not interfere in the word of the first Adam. He came floating, and floating he went away. So he left no mark on this earth, you know. So I will, if you want to see my other videos, you will enjoy it. And if you, anybody who want to have a discussion, heart to heart, he can do so on Skype. I like Skype, it's a very easy one to use. And my Skype is my email, which is ninja@gmail.com.